do it. Harvey needed you. Why save me?
I haven't actually seen it yet. You've had me wrapped up this whole time. Numbed beyond belief. Maybe it's not that bad.
Our stock is tanking. The board is losing confidence. Wayne Enterprises needs a new face. Oswald Cobblepot.
You're the only ally I have in this building. It's important. I need you to be my eyes and ears.
All right, I can do that.
Keep Oswald out of R&D. Let me know if anything comes up.
You're a good man, Bruce.
I think you may have misinterpreted things.
Oh. Sorry.
Please, Selena, I have to tell you how I... Bruce?
Selena, I think you should get out of Gotham. It's not just Harvey. The children of Arkham are after you. It's not safe right now.
Yeah. Maybe you're right.
Dropped your pen?
It's not...
It's time you knew my real name. I am Lady Arkham.
You have to face the truth sometime.
Retribution, Bruce.
Okay, I'm up. I'm up.
And for Christ's sake, put some clothes on. The doctor's making the rounds soon.
Doctor? What doctor? Is that my blood? God, I hope it's mine. Arkham Asylum. This can't be happening. Looks like someone was angry. Lovely. Can't be real.
Better be decent. You settled? Good. Anything you need? Water, piss, rat poison? I've been asked for rope before. Not really allowed to give it out. Of course, I could make an exception for you.
You can tell me why I'm in Arkham Asylum for a start.
What, rich boy doesn't remember? Oswald Cobblepot? You beat him to a bloody pulp. Nearly killed him. Landed you here. Any of this ringing a bell? Might as well get comfortable. This is your home now. Time to meet your neighbors. Hey. As you were.
You look just like him. Your father ever tell you about me? How he sent me here? Left me to rot in this goddamn hellhole? Somebody's gotta pay for that. I hope to God there is a hell.
You really don't want to do this.
You don't know a damn thing about me, Wayne.
I appreciate the help.
You're welcome. If we don't look out for each other, who will, right?
What is going on in here?
It's like I told you, Doctor. These creeps were attacking the new guy.
Well, who did that? Was it you?
Of course not. It was mostly over by the time I got in. The new guy's tougher than he looks. Right, buddy?
Bruce, is that really what happened?
Go on, tell her.
Yeah, that's what happened.
We have a very strict no-fighting policy here in Arkham. If you can't obey that rule, you're going to find yourself in hot water fast.
The orderly that was here before took money from these men and let them into my room. He gave them a taser.
I knew that you coming to Arkham could cause some excitement, but I didn't expect it to happen so fast. I'll do my best to keep you safe, but I need you to be careful.
Us nice guys gotta stick together. Am I right?
Don't worry. I'm always careful.
And you seem to be able to defend yourself quite well. Still, better to play it safe. You were lucky. Help came so quickly.
Hey, I'm just looking out for the new guy.
I'm Dr. Joan Leland, by the way, head of psychiatry. I'll be overseeing your case personally. We'll get you transferred to a new room, Bruce. One that doesn't have your blood all over it. For now, follow me.
I'm sorry, I don't think I ever got your name.
Me?
He's never given his name out to anybody.
What?
We just call him John Doe.
Bingo.
John is one of our most improved patients. He's been with us for quite some time. I'm sure he'd be willing to show you around. Right, John?
Oh, yeah. I'll show him the whole nine yards.
I think it would be best if you stayed by his side.
But there's not enough black tiles, you hear me? There's too many white tiles!
Our last session was so enlightening.
That's good to hear. Your next evaluation is in a few weeks. I'm glad you're starting to understand yourself better.
Oh, every day, Doctor.
I can't taste anything! I want a taste!
You gotta be more careful, Bruce. Some of these guys bite. Remember the first time you let me into the rec room, Dr. Leland?
How could I forget?
You had to teach me how to play checkers.
Yes, well...
No! No, you need to let me go. I have to warn the president. You're trying to kill me.
You don't know the president.
No!
They don't like it when you try to use the phone.
That's because phones are for staff use only. No exceptions.
Then stop that guy from trying. Such persistence.
Wrong number, dumbass!
Stop! I'll come by to check on you two later.
Don't worry about us, Dr. Leland.
Take good care of him.
Welcome to Arkham Asylum! Believe it or not, some of these people are crazy. But everyone's friendly, mostly. I'd watch yourself around those two. Not a big fan of strangers.
Thanks for the heads up. I appreciate you showing me around like this.
I'm a giver. What can I say? I always try to keep an eye out for new guys. Let's see. On the couch, that's St. Louis. Ooh, his favorite show's on. Never misses it. All right, friendo. Commercial break. Get up! There is the remote. One of the orderlies must have taken it. Never fear, though. I'll go ask Leland. She likes me. Ooh! I almost forgot. Here.
What is this? Hello?
Hello?
Go away! Arnold's busy. I swear, if you bother him, I will gut you.
Any idea what this opens?
Did John give you that key? Not this again.
Wait, not what again?
Nothing. Just go away. I'm busy here.
You heard him. Beat him.
If that's the way the cookie crumbles...
Batman really did a number on this guy. Just let him be.
I solved the cookie riddle, not you. Sorry.
Sorry, I can't talk right now. I gotta keep my eye on this guy. Hey there, buddy boy. You missed me? I missed you.
However, the threat remains. The children of Arkham are still out there, and I will not rest until these streets are safe and firmly under my control.
Never anything good on, is there?
My enforcement squad has already seen great success. They stopped a massive attack being organized out of a local SkyTrain depot.
Politicians usually bore me to tears, but this one has become a lot more interesting lately.
In my Gotham, no one's above the law, including Bruce Wayne. After his vicious attack on Oswald Cobblepot, I had Mr. Wayne committed to Arkham Asylum, where I hope he'll receive the treatment he so desperately needs.
Double-crossing, two-faced.
I thought you and the mayor were friends. I mean, you were supporting his campaign.
Harvey was my friend. I can't believe he's the one who put me here.
Sounds like you need better friends. Slim pickings around here, though. I've looked.
in which Mayor Dent announced the creation of a special enforcement squad under his direct command to combat an imminent threat from the children of Arkham.
Rest assured, we will find these terrorists, their stockpile of drugs, and their leader, this Lady Arkham, before they can strike again.
Now, this is good television! Mayor on her rampage versus freaky drug terrorist.
I'm gonna find your drugs.
I'm going to expose your corruption.
Harvey is going way too far.
You think so? I can't wait to see where he goes next!
Tragically, there's still no sign of Gotham Gazette reporter Vicki Vale after her mysterious disappearance earlier this week.
Very tricky, Vicki. I think we both know she's quite the, lady, right, Bruce?
Wait. You know that Vicki is... Tell me what you know.
You wanna find Vicki and her drugs, huh? Getting your revenge just like you got your revenge on Cobblepot? Publicly and dramatically! Something entertaining for these newscasters to talk about.
Well, that all depends on you. If your information is good, we'll see.
I knew I liked you. I've been watching you for a while now, Bruce. And I can tell there's something darker in you. When you attacked Oswald, I could tell you enjoyed it. If those cops hadn't dragged you off of him, that Cobblepot punk would be dead!
You don't know anything about me.
No? Well, to my eyes, you're a lot like that dad of yours. And I'm a big fan of his work. Taking out his enemies by making them crazy made this place a hell of a lot more interesting. It's obvious that's why Vicki hates you.
Your dad helped bump off her parents.
Why would my father have the Vales killed?
I never said he killed the Vales. She was born in Arkham. Victoria Arkham.
What?
You didn't know that?
The Arkhams did not approve of what your dad and his partners were doing. They were gonna blow the whistle on the whole thing, so your dad, well, pop, pop. Her parents murdered, leaving her with an unquenchable thirst for vengeance. Surely you can relate. Tragedy can drive people to do some pretty dark stuff.
Yeah, I can relate to that. Tragedy can be a powerful motivation.
I knew it. I knew it. Very good instincts on this sort of thing.
You and Vicki are both dark souls, and now you're heading on a collision course towards each other. That's gonna be fantastic. You see, I know what you really are.
And that's why I really want to tell you where Vicki's moved her drugs, but you're not going to do anything while you're stuck in here. So, I vote we get you out. How hard can it be? You're Bruce Wayne.
The Waynes always get what they want.
All it would take is a phone call.
Well, sure, but there's no phone.
Assume I can take care of that.
It's gonna come at a price. When I get out of here, you're gonna owe me a favor, okay?
Just one.
Yeah, I don't know what it is yet. But what's one favor between friends?
Sure, one favor, that seems fair.
Excellent. We'll have loads of fun. You'll see.
All right, tell you what, I'm gonna make a distraction to get the guards away from that gate. The rest is up to you.
You make that phone call, and I promise I'll tell you how to find those missing drugs.
Hey, Zaz! Hello, Zaz.
What the hell do you want?
settle a bet. What happens if you make a tally mark before you kill someone?
What are you talking about? Ah! No!
No, I don't match him.
Oh, God, I don't match!
You can fix that right now!
Skin feels like it's itching. Burning! Need to get rid of it!
Pat, stop! Someone get me a sedative! Run, Brucey! Run! Call security!
GCPD.
Gordon, it's Bruce Wayne.
Wayne? Aren't you supposed to be in Arkham Asylum?
Listen, Gordon, I haven't lost my mind. I was drugged. The same drug the Children of Arkham used on Montoya and Harvey Dent.
You get me out of here, and I'm willing to testify.
This might help our case, actually. That makes three victims now, and Renee says she's got some new evidence. If you're willing to testify, I think I can get you out of there.
Thanks. I have to go.
Oh, Bruce, I have not had this much fun in ages.
Let me tell you how to find Vicky's stash of missing drugs. Ask the Vales.
Quickly, come on.
Good luck on the outside, Bruce. I just
know you're gonna put on quite a show.
Pretty grisly scene in there. Multiple stabbings. One of the orderlies had a finger bitten off.
If you're looking for who to blame, maybe start with the mirror, because you're the one that left violent psychotics unattended.
Mr. Wayne, I understand you have been through a trying day, but that does not give you the freedom to criticize me or this facility in that way. Because from my perspective, my patients were fine until you went into that rec room today. One moment. Seems you have a visitor.
Alfred.
Ah, Bruce. Thank heavens you're all right. You see, everything is in order. Signed this morning with Lieutenant Gordon of the GCPD. He is to be released into my care.
I know it seems like using your power and influence is the best way to make this all go away. But it's just avoiding the problem. What happened with those men in your room? The riot with Zaz? You clearly need help, Bruce. He needs extensive evaluation, treatment.
Dr. Leland, you know it isn't safe for me here. Look at what happened today. That won't be the last time.
That may be true, but I would never let that hinder someone from getting the help they need.
I'm afraid it's out of your hands now, Doctor. You have the paperwork.
Let's go, Alfred.
I will see you on the outside, Bruce.
I can't wait!
What's that about?
Believe that Lady Arkham was actually Vicky Vale this entire time.
And all the while she was working with Cobblepot to try and bring me down.
Did Lieutenant Gordon hear about this lead when he let you out?
Not yet. Batman will handle this one first.
Even during Batman's brief hiatus, Gotham has become that much more dangerous. And the public opinion on Bruce Wayne, Well, it certainly hasn't gotten any better.
I don't care about public opinion. And neither should you, Al.
I wish I could agree with you. But the more people call out for you to receive justice, the harder your other job could become.
Selena?
Good to know Miss Kyle's keeping in touch from wherever she is now.
In other news, if you've noticed, the streets of Gotham have been a lot quieter recently. You're not alone. The GCPD has reported a sudden and steep drop in violent crime in the past few days, with the number of 911 calls falling off a whopping 60%. Many are attributing it to the decrease in the visibility of the terrorist group Children of Arkham, whose members seem to be taking some time off. Or maybe it's just our new Mayor Dent making good on his campaign promise to bring down crime in the city. Either way, the citizens are breathing a sigh of relief.
Hello, Harvey.
You should have stayed in the asylum where I put you.
What do you want, Harvey?
The streets of Gotham are a dangerous place for someone like you right now. Well, you'll figure that out. Eventually. But by then, it'll be too late.
Just leave me the hell alone, Harvey. Trust me, it'll be easier for you in the long run.
I was doing you a favor, Bruce. If you want to get ugly, well, that can be arranged. Maybe you haven't heard, but the Children of Arkham have gone underground. Obviously plotting some sort of attack, and people are scared, panicking. I needed to show them that my resolve hasn't weakened, that Gotham is still strong. So I gave them an enemy. You and your family's filthy corruption. The last thing I need is you traipsing around Gotham.
Would you listen to yourself? You sound insane.
No. I'm just a man who's done letting assholes like you run the world and take whatever they want. Can't let you keep running around scot-free, Bruce. It's the will of the people.
You can spare me your will of the people crap, Harvey. I know this is personal.
You knew I was interested in Selina. What you did was a low blow, Bruce. A real man wouldn't have done that. A friend wouldn't have done that.
She doesn't belong to you, Harvey. She can see whoever she wants.
Do not lecture me about Selina. Bruce? Bruce!
We're done talking. What's going on here?
Well, well, well. Bruce Wayne. You really must have done something to piss the mayor off so much, hmm? Maybe I'll get a bonus for this. Open the trunk. We're searching the car. If we find anything tying you to the Children of Arkham, including drugs, weapons, or any other suspicious materials, you will be taken into custody.
I know my goddamn rights, and you better have a warrant to back that up.
Don't need one. Mayor Dent gave his enforcers full search and seizure rights.
Come on, what's the damn holdup?
Get back to your car!
Of course. Should've known. Go back to Arkham, you damn maniac!
The hell?
Careful, or you'll be the next Cobblepot!
Showing your face in public like this? Not real smart! Nothing to say, huh?
They should lock you up!
Oh, God, Alfred, I'm sorry. I don't...
You'll be fine. We just need to get out of this mess.
Nowhere to run, dirtbag! Next one won't be a warning shot!
All right, now the way I see it, there are two ways we can do this, Bruce Wayne. Either I let these people at you and see how you handle mob justice, or you could make a little donation to me and my boys to help us stay well-funded, hmm? And well-armed? What do you say?
They've got us blocked in. I can't back up. This is turning ugly, sir.
What would you like to do?
Hey, the mayor's gonna hear about this, and it ain't gonna make him happy.
Hey, he's the problem, not us!
Here. It's everything I have, okay?
Sure, that'll work.
This isn't over.
Yeah, sure. Take it up with City Hall.
Sir? Just get us home, Al. Fast. I'm fine, okay? I just need to get to the computer.
You're exhausted. And the influence of Lady Arkham's drug may still be affecting you.
Harvey is turning Gotham into a police state. Oswald has stolen my company, and we need to find Vicky and the Children of Arkham before they strike again. I can't just ignore it.
You're in no condition to work. You absolutely must get some rest.
I don't have time for rest.
You'll be no good to anyone if you can barely keep your feet under you.
You're right. Let's just focus on getting my head clear first. Bring up everything we know about Vicky Vale's drug.
Yes, of course.
If I can isolate the presence of the drug, I should be able to synthesize an antidote. Start a DNA scan. Compare it to my DNA on file in the back computer.
I'll make the preparations.
This is the refined sample of the drug taken from Officer Montoya after she killed Falcone. Here's my DNA before the incident. It seems that the drug attaches itself to specific proteins in the genome structure. If we can modify the drug's molecular structure, we should be able to create a counteragent.
Once you've figured this out, we'll have a working antidote. We can cure others affected by the drug.
No. I wish that were possible. This cure is based on my DNA. It'll only work for me. To cure other people, we'd have to sample and decode the genome structure for each and every person to make them an antidote.
We don't have the time or resources for that.
That's why we were lucky to have mine on file already. That should do it. This needs to be injected directly into the vein to work.
I don't imagine it'll be much fun. Hopefully that does the trick.
It'll work, Alfred. I feel better already.
So, what are we going to do now?
First things first, I need to know what Vicky, Lady Arkham, has been up to while I've been away. Search for all Children of Arkham recent activity. The press is reporting that Vicky Vale is missing.
Yes, and obviously the police have yet to find a body. That woman, trying to get the scoop on you, pretending to care. She betrayed you.
I wish things had been different. Maybe I could have gotten through to her.
You always try your best, Bruce. She had her own agenda from the start.
She was playing me the entire time, breaking me down. She wanted me in Arkham. She wanted me to feel what my father had done to all those people.
Bruce.
There were bigger plans than me, Alfred. Batman stopped her at the Skyrail station. And I can't believe that she isn't finding another way to use the drugs.
Well, if that's true, she may be more dangerous than ever.
I know. I met someone in Arkham who gave me a tip on how to find her.
A tip? Do you really think you can trust someone in Arkham Asylum? Offense intended toward your recent time there, of course.
No, I absolutely don't trust him. The man is psychotic.
Wonderful. Well, let's try to steer clear of him in the future, shall we?
He told me that if I want to know what she's planning, then I should visit her parents' house.
If the Vales still live in Gotham, they should be easy enough to locate.
Got it.
Bruce!
Yeah? If you do find Miss Vale, please, be careful.
I'm inside the Vale House. Alfred, the Vales are dead. One body confirmed, but there is a lot of blood. Alert Gordon.
Will do.
I don't know how this is connected to the drugs yet. Whatever they knew about it, Vicky made sure they kept quiet. Syringe. Seems she hasn't given up her old tricks.
Is this the same drug?
Yes, but this is several times stronger than the dosage I received.
Maybe she's escalating.
This seems personal. There's an injection wound on her neck. Same kind Montoya and I both received, but this one's much worse. Her eyes are gone. Stabbed out.
That's disturbing.
Same device, same drug. This confirms that Lady Arkham is the murderer. I found a lock of hair.
Anything unique about it?
It was cut at a downward angle, probably with some force based on how clean the slice is. It's clean. This wasn't used as a murder weapon.
Then why was it lying on the floor?
It appears Mrs. Vale attempted to fight back with this knife, but only managed to slice through the attacker's hair. Alfred, found Mr. Vale.
Alive?
No. He's gone. 10 hours at least, judging by the state of his soft tissues. Looks like a company logo. The belt buckle is covered in blood. Before he was hung with the belt, Mr. Vale was beaten with it.
Recent family photo.
Vicky's not in it. It shows the Vales with another child in front of an industrial office. There's a logo on the building. The logos match. Mr. Vale owned an oil and heating company.
Looking it up now. Yes, he's got a sizable warehouse in the industrial district, and a fleet of delivery trucks.
And now Vicky's got it. Large amounts of blood spatter across the walls. It's not steady like arterial spray. Someone was swinging wildly. Wait, there's a slight indentation where something bloody struck the wall with force.
Something thrown.
Nothing I can see. The indentation matches the shape of the belt buckle. It must have impacted with the wall during the attack.
What exactly happened in that house?
I think I know. After we stopped her at the rail station, Vicky needed a place to hide her supply of drugs. Her father's trucks and warehouse offered the perfect cover. To do that, she needed them out of the way. With Vicky Vale fully assuming her new identity of Lady Arkham, seems like she didn't need the veils around to support her old one. Vicky showed up to attack her adopted parents, but only the mother was there at first. Miss Vale fought back and was able to slice off part of Vicky's hair. Vicky then subdued her with the same drug she used on me, but a much, much larger dose. Nearly lethal. She then removed the mother's eyes, indicating a deeply personal motivation. This was obviously some sort of vendetta. Sometime during this, Mr. Vale entered. Vicky attacked him with his own belt, striking with the buckle until he was unconscious and bleeding out. Finally, she dragged him to the closet and hung him with the belt. The blood loss got him way before the hanging did.
That's horrific. She never acted out in such a violent way before. Why would she...
Alfred, I think someone's still in the house, going to look for a heat signature. If anyone else is here, I'll find them. Clear. Nothing here.
Anything?
No. There's someone here, under the stairs, alive. It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you.
Sir, is everything all right?
It's a kid, Alfred. The boy from the photo.
Is he all right?
Aside from the shock and a few bruises, he seems okay. He might be able to tell me more about what happened.
Possibly. But if that's the road you go down, please do it with caution.
Hey, it's gonna be okay. You're gonna be all right. Why are you hiding?
I heard screams. Lots of screams. So I hid. I didn't see what happened.
I need you to tell me if you saw or heard anything. This is important.
I heard someone say something. Something about drugs, fighting the police. I don't know who. I don't know who because I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything because I hid in here. Please don't send me to punishment.
Calm down. See, that does help me. Thank you.
Get down!
Figure out our next move. Figure out where the drugs are. Did I get it? Am I close? Pathetic. I've got these little back traps all over the city, but I should have known a good double murder would be what brought you out in the open. Ah!
Nice work, kid.
They're dead.
Yes, they are. But you are not. You're still alive. And those emotions you're feeling, someday you'll learn how to use them, to channel them. You might not understand now, but someday it will make you stronger. I promise, I won't stop until I catch the person that did this. You're the kid who saved Batman, and no matter what happens, no matter where you go, that will always be true, and I will always owe you one.
Batman.
Oh my God.
He was the only survivor.
Come on. Let's get you out of here.
He saved me.
Oh, Jesus. Was this the Children of Arkham? Again? Why would they attack a family like the Vales? Because their daughter Vicky is Lady Arkham. She killed her own parents so she could use their company warehouse to stockpile the rest of her drugs. Vicky? Vicky Vale, the reporter? And so, who was the boy then? Just make sure he's taken care of and doesn't fall through the cracks. After what he's been through, he needs a good home. Yeah, I actually know the drill. He says he heard something about drugs and attacking the police. Can't confirm anything, but it sounds like the Children of Arkham might be plotting something with those drugs against your people. Thanks for the heads up. The warehouse is Vale Oil and Heating. You should secure it as soon as possible. I'll get on it right away. What about you? I've got something I need to look into.
Lieutenant, what's going on here?
Securing the crime scene, Commissioner.
Not anymore, you're not. I'm taking over this investigation. I can't risk you allowing Batman to contaminate our crime scene again.
And so your bat stunner just didn't work?
That's right. I have a bad feeling it was no accident. Alfred, get Lucius on the line for me, please.
Of course.
Let's get a closer look at you. No damage on the microfiber. Adhesion regulation reads normal. EMP functionality is all in the green. It should have worked. Electricity conductor, everything looks functional. This doesn't make any sense. This is strange. This microchip is emitting a low bandwidth receiving signal, but it shouldn't be.
Like the ones you shut down in the GCPD.
Something like that. But Lucius had his eyes on the Wayne tech that the Children of Arkham breached. This is something different.
Bruce, I have Lucius on screen now.
Good evening, Bruce. How can I help?
I need you to see something. Sending you schematics.
God, someone's found a way to get past my security upgrades.
Not just someone. Oswald Cobblepot.
Bruce, I am so sorry. I should have caught this, but he snuck right under my nose. Oh, what a mess. That sleaze cobblepot at the heart of it all.
Don't waste time beating yourself up about it, Lucius. Let's just focus on fixing it.
Right, right. Looks to me like he's introduced some sort of bug into your network.
That's how he's making my equipment malfunction?
For now, but if he keeps it up, he could completely take control of your tech.
My lord, that would be catastrophic.
Is there anything you can do?
I can try to work on your firewalls. But if I do anything too drastic, he'll know we're onto him.
I'm tired of being on the defensive. Why don't we attack him instead?
I'm not sure, but I can certainly see what I can do.
Thanks, Lucius.
Bruce, you're going to want to see this.
Excuse us, Lucius.
Of course. Reports of Children of Arkham activity are down. But these efforts do not come cheap. That's why I am formally seizing the Wayne estate, so the corrupt wealth of Gotham's elite goes to the better purpose of protecting Gotham's common man. Mr. Wayne has 24 hours to evacuate his property and turn it over to the city, or he will be removed.
You can't let that egomaniac throw us out on the street.
I have to talk to him.
After what happened at the debate, Harvey probably isn't the biggest fan of Batman. On the other hand, perhaps Bruce Wayne can appeal to him on a more personal level.
Harvey's behavior is unpredictable. Random. Who knows how he will react either way?
This is Bruce's problem, not Batman's. I'll take care of it.
I believe in you, Bruce. I know you can get through to him.
I don't know if that was the right thing to do. Why did I do that? Don't screw this up, Harvey.
Harvey, we need to talk.
If you've come to save your home, you're wasting your time. My mind is made up.
I have always supported you.
Really? How were you supporting me when you pulled the funding from my campaign the night I was attacked?
Look, I know you're still pissed off at me about Selina, but I swear to you, nothing happened. You have to stop this. Now.
Gotham deserves a mayor that can focus on cleaning up this city. That's why I'm taking your money, your home, everything. It's time that you started paying your debt to Gotham. The value of your estate, it could be used to do a lot of good.
It's not my debt to pay. What my parents did was not my fault.
Nobody cares. The deal is done. A strong leader doesn't back down. When they see an enemy, they crush them without hesitation. I made a promise to the city that I would make it better. That I would weed out the crime and corruption.
You're better than this, Harvey. And I'm not giving up on you. Not yet. You can still change things for the better.
You're right. And it starts with taking down the Children of Arkham.
What do you mean?
Ready to go.
Do it.
What the hell did you do?
Our Lady Arkham's drugs destroyed.
That blast was way bigger than you said! We must have taken out a whole city block with it! Hey, man, we lost a bunch of our own guys! The apartment next door! Oh, Jesus Christ!
We stopped the Children of Arkham. That's all that matters. That's what a leader does.
Hey, how quickly can we get a fire truck here?
Does a leader kill innocent people? You're a murderer now.
Their deaths are unfortunate. But think about everyone the Children of Arkham could have hurt with those drugs. That feels like an acceptable price to pay. I couldn't just destroy the drugs. I had to make a statement. I needed the Children of Arkham and any other potential enemies waiting in the shadows to know what I'm capable of. That I'll do anything to protect my city. That I am the guardian of Gotham.
After what you've done tonight, everyone in Gotham is going to see who they really elected mayor. And when that happens, they will turn against you.
On the contrary, Bruce, this is what Gotham wanted. Oh, I can see tomorrow's headlines already. Hero Mayor saves citizens from Children of Arkham terror plot. Meanwhile, somewhere in the back they'll stick the article about Bruce Wayne's tragic suicide.
What the hell are you talking about?
All the shame you've suffered was just too much for you to bear. Your family's history, getting forced out of your company, losing all your money. No one will question finding you dead in Crime Alley so soon after you got out of Arkham. Tragic, but unsurprising. Maybe even dear old Alfred will shed a tear.
Come on, keep walking.
Wait. Shut up!
Just wait.
Just keep moving.
Please, why are you doing this?
Hey, he said shut up!
I know that when you put that uniform on in the morning, you do it because you want to help Gotham. You are better than this. This is not how you help the city.
You need to do a little bad to do a lot of good. The Children of Arkham are trying to tear the city apart. We're saving it.
Yeah, we finally got a leader who wants results.
Harvey's not gonna save Gotham. He's going to destroy it.
No, he won't.
Look at what he's already done tonight. Do you think that's gonna be the last city block he blows up to get his way?
I hadn't thought about it that way.
Hey, don't listen to his crap. The mayor's the only one brave enough to take real action against our enemies.
Your mayor just blew up a city block.
Sometimes to help the greater good, there's a price to pay.
People died. Your fellow officers died.
But
if you think that's where he's gonna stop, you're just as crazy as he is.
Maybe he has a point.
Shut up! You just don't get it! You don't understand! That's why we need to take you out.
Maybe...
Maybe what?
Nothing.
Go on then. Pull the trigger. Do it.
You're right. Oh God, I was about... I'm sorry.
I knew you didn't have the stones for this.
Officer! Drop your weapon! You okay?
Yeah. You really showed up in the nick of time. How'd you even find me? Dent just blew up a whole city block.
I know. The reports I'm hearing are just awful. Dent's gone way, way too far. He's supposedly trying to stop the Children of Arkham, but now he's become a goddamn terrorist himself. A terrorist with half the city's support behind him. The amount of blood on his hands. He and Lady Arkham might be neck and neck on body count by this point.
I just don't understand how this could happen. He's not emperor, he's just mayor.
He's declared martial law. Basically, whatever he says goes, if he believes it's for the good of the city. I can't help but feel guilty. Batman gave me the information on where to find Lady Arkham's drug stockpile. I hand it into my superiors and... God, this happens. I'm trying to figure out what I can do to help. But I feel like my hands are tied every direction I turn. Grogan's out for Batman's head, as soon as he can figure out a way to do it. I've never felt this frustrated with a system in my entire career.
Harvey's power comes from abusing the system. Maybe you should let someone outside of the system take care of him. Like Batman.
I'm going to pretend I didn't hear that. But Noted. Everything is such a goddamn mess. Do you need a ride?
Thanks, but I've got it taken care of.
What's the situation?
I figured out how he's causing the feedback loop. He's somehow connected a black box computer to your encrypted network. God, it's like a digital battering ram. If he keeps this up, he could smash through the Batcave firewalls at any minute.
He'd have access to the Bat computer. Hang on, Lucius. It's Alfred. I'm patching him in. Al, Lucius figured out how Penguin's cracking my security. He has a device that...
I'm afraid we have another problem to deal with. Mr. Dent is pulling up to the manor as we speak, and he's not alone.
Already?
Sir, are you all right?
Penguin's hacking assaults are getting worse. At this rate, he'll have my tech compromised by the end of the night. Only place he could be hacking me from is Wayne Enterprises.
Well, I don't envy your position. Even Batman can't be in two places at once.
I'm going home.
Understood. See you soon. Not one step further.
Now come on, Al. Put the rifle down. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Somehow, I don't believe you.
Back away, please. All of you.
Jesus, Al, it's me. Harvey.
No, not the Harvey I know. The Harvey I know would never have massacred innocent civilians. He isn't a murderer.
Murderer? When a general sends his troops to kill the enemy, no one calls it murder. They call it war. I am going to win the war against the children.
Penguin is still hacking my tech.
Casualties?
Guess I'll be doing this the old-fashioned way.
What are you doing here?
You've destroyed enough lives for one night. I'm taking you in.
Oh, I get it. You'll come to Bruce Wayne's aid when he needs it, but not mine. No, not when I needed it. You let that maniac Penguin maim me! Look at me! This happened under your watch! And you call yourself a hero.
I can't save everybody.
No. No, you can't. You didn't save me. And you didn't save Bruce. He's dead. If you can't see the good I've done for this city, then you're no better than Lady Arkham. Or the Waynes. Now get out of here! Before I have you booked for obstruction of justice. You stand in my way. You stand in the way of the law. This, Harvey.
I know.
Know what those are? Explosive slugs! But you don't have any of those in that little belt of yours! Just try and hide, Batman! See how that works out for you. No! The Bat's mine!
Go ahead. Do it. See what happens. This old man needs to die. Your head or your heart? What's that sound?
What the?
Dent. Your ego and your anger stoked the fires until everything was burning. The fact you can't see that shows how deep your delusion goes.
No. I'm important. I'm important!
Thank God he was finally stopped. Nice work, Batman.
My job's not done yet. I still need to find Lady Arkham before it's too late.
Well, I can take care of all this. Just need to figure out what to do with him. All the innocent lives he's responsible for, he should be locked up in Blackgate Prison. But that broken mind of his will probably only get worse in there.
Den is too dangerous and too damaged to be kept in some holding cell at Blackgate. You have to get him into Arkham. They might actually be able to help him in there.
Yeah, you're right. I'll see what I can do. Meantime, you stay safe out there, all right?
You too, Jim.
Al. Al, what's
Bruce,
wrong?
The computer.
It's Penguin.
We need to cut the hardline now.
Bruce. All of your Bat-Tech is linked to this computer. If you take it offline, it will all be inoperable.
If Penguin hacks in, he'll have control of all of it. I have to shut it down!